chicken nuggets. Everybody loves them. And do you know they were developed in the 1950s by Robert Baker, a food science professor at Cornell University? And of course, you can buy them anywhere like Mickey D's, and they are good, I have to admit. But why not make them at home where you can be your own food professor and know what goes into them? So let me show you how to do this. The first thing I'm going to do is add 2.5 cups of cornflakes, yes, plain old cornflakes, into the bowl of my Magico's food processor. Slip the lid on. Pulse them up for a few minutes, and you can set the speed to 4 or 5 as well, until they are fairly fine. And I do want to stress you want this fairly fine indeed, and if you don't have a food processor, you can just slip the cornflakes into a Ziploc bag and just kind of pound the heck out of them until they are fine. Then, in with a cup of powdered Parmesan, and you can use finely grated too, and once again, mix this up. And if you're using the old Ziploc bag technique, just slip the Parmesan into the bag and give it a good shake. Now we'll just go ahead and put that wonderful coating into a bowl. Okay, the next thing you want to do is grab up 8 boneless, skinless chicken thighs, you can use breasts too, and put them into the bowl of the food processor. Followed by a couple of tablespoons of water. A few good cracks of salt, about a teaspoon. The same amount, maybe a little bit more, of ground black pepper. A teaspoon of onion powder. And a good, good teaspoon of my all-time favorite, garlic powder. And seeing this video was brought to you by the good folks over at Magico's, I just have to mention this food processor, guys, and I do really, really like it. I mean, it has your 7 speeds and a good powerful motor, plus the pulse feature, which really comes in handy. And the feature I like so much is that storage drawer below to keep all of your blades. And of course, I'll put all the links and information in the description section below. Now I'm going to use the chopper blade today and really put this machine to the test by grinding up those chicken thighs. Okay, we had a little bit of a shake at the beginning, but really, it seems to be doing a great job. It's grinding up those thighs really well. I have to say, I'm fairly impressed. And of course, if you don't have a food processor, go ahead and use ground chicken. I just like making my own. I just have this thing about making my own ground chicken, ground pork, ground beef, whatever it might be. Okay, we have our chicken all ground up, and this is about the texture you want right about here. I don't know, it's kind of close to the stuff you get at the grocery store. And at least you know what's in it. There are no lips or eyeballs or anything like that. So I'm going to do my next little trick here and put this on a baking sheet lined with some parchment paper. Then just kind of spread it out evenly. Now you might say, why on earth are you doing that? Well, I'm going to slip this into the freezer for a few minutes, so therefore it freezes evenly. And when I scoop up the nuggets, I get even amounts. So into the freezer for 25 minutes. Now we're nicely firmed up. I'm going to scoop up a ball of this and place it into the palm of my hand. And just kind of roll it into a ball, flatten it out, and design it into a nice, cute little chicken nugget. Doesn't that look fantastic, guys? Now we are all formed up, we're going into that cornflake mixture, and you know, you can use breadcrumbs too, I just like the cornflakes. I suppose I have a bit of Jethro Bodine in me. Okay, our fancy dancy chicken McNuggets are going onto a baking tray lined with some parchment paper. Then into a 375 degree preheated oven for about 20 or 25 minutes. After about 25 minutes, they are done, and oh, just look at these guys. It is chicken nugget time. So let's go ahead and plate these up and make them look all fancy nuggety-like. Okay, my friends, let's cut into this and see what we have here. Just look at this. I think this looks absolutely fantastic. Wow. And they're not crunchy because they've been done in the oven. If you wanted them really crunchy, you'd have to deep fry them, but they are good. Dip these into the ketchup or your favorite dipping sauce. And guys, when you bite into these, they are absolutely fantastic. I don't think Dr. Robert Baker could have done better himself. I don't think Ronald McDonald could have done better. They are just simply a must make.